Okay, so here we are, calculus integrals part one, day number four. We're going to touch today on u substitution and change the variable. Tomorrow, Wednesday, we will talk about integration by parts. Archimedes' method at this point should be getting better. It may not be perfect, but it should be getting better. Here's a little extra practice if you want it. You can go ahead and practice that stuff, but we're not going to touch on that right now. So integration by substitution is the formal name, but we use u substitution. Typically, u is the variable involved. I'm not going to talk about this slide. This is the formal definition of u substitution. You can look at it on your own time. I want to get right to the nitty-gritty here. Okay. U substitution is something that, with practice, can become very easy. If you don't practice this, obviously it will be much more difficult. A couple of things that I want to highlight here. Do you know your derivatives? Maybe? Some of them? With polynomials? Polynomials should be like cash money in the bank, right? Take the power, bring it down, reduce it by one, right? I'd like to bring to your attention this first problem here. I already have the answer up. You can see that. We're going to get there. But if you look at the denominator, what's the derivative of the denominator? That's the numerator, right? Okay, pause for a second. Now let's look at number two. Let's look at number two, or the second one. What's the derivative of 1 minus x squared? Negative 2x. It's pretty closely related to this, right? It's just not negative 2. But there is an x involved. So you see that the power has reduced and it reduces to this other thing. Now, that's just a nice little intro to what I'm about to do, which is we're going to use a variable and we're going to call that variable u. Right? I'm going to call this thing, this x squared or x cubed plus 2x u. Now, what if I take the derivative of u, du? Well, we know that will be 3x squared plus 2 dx. Right? So du dx. Maybe I should stop here for a second. Let me do this. I'm going to take the derivative of u with respect to x. Okay. Derivative of u with respect to x would be 3x squared plus 2x. Excuse me, plus 2. Wow, thank you. Now, what I'm going to do is I want to substitute in. I want to get rid of any x or dx that I see. So I'm going to simplify, and I'm going to simplify writing out du equals 3x squared plus 2 times dx. Now, what I see up here in our problem is I see 3x squared plus 2 times dx. What am I going to replace that with? Du, right? And what am I going to replace the denominator with? U. So as I rewrite, I replace 3x squared plus 2x plus 2 dx with du. So I'm taking the integral of 1 over u du, which is really pretty easy, right? What's the integral of 1 over u? Ln u. Ln u. It is not. Right? We're not going to take u to the negative 1 power and then work the opposite way because we'll get u to the 0, right? And we'll have a problem. So is the derivative, what's the derivative of the natural log of x? 1 over x. So what's the integral of 1 over x? Natural log of x, right? I'm just going backwards here. Backwards and forward. That's the hardest part about this, to keep this straight. So the derivative, the integral of 1 over u du is the natural log of u plus c. However, Diogo, you asked this question a couple weeks ago. Don't we have to use absolute value? Yes, we do. We do because the integral has to satisfy the domain of the function that it becomes. What's the domain of the natural log? Greater than 0. So that's why we use the absolute value. Okay, so I'm not done. What does u equal? Well, u equals x cubed plus 2x. So I plug it back in. I got my integral, my antiderivative. So the key at the beginning, let me pause this for a second. The key at number 2, what would I call u here? 1 minus x squared. So du dx is negative 2x. Okay, so I'm going to bring that dx over to the other side. So du equals negative 2x dx. But it doesn't, I don't see a negative 2x dx, but I do see an x dx, right? So what should I do with the negative 2? Bring it over to the other side. I'm going to divide by negative 2, which means I'll have negative 1 half du equals x dx. And now I can sub in. Okay. So let's just do a little substitution here. So x dx is going to be replaced by negative 1 du, 1 half du. What am I going to replace e to the 1 minus x squared with? E to the u. Right? E to the u. Let's do this. Okay, so I'm going to take the integral, and I'm actually going to take this negative 1 half, and I'm going to bring it out in front. You can always bring a constant out in front of the integral. That just makes life easier on the inside. So then I'm going to leave the du at the end, and I'm going to have e to the u. Have I accounted for everything? Yeah, I have a negative 1 half du, which was x dx, and I have e to the u, which was e to the 1 minus x squared. Now I simplify. What's the integral of e to the u? E to the u. So I get negative 1 half e to the u plus c, and of course u is 1 minus x squared. Boom. Done. Sweet. Okay, so for those of you at home, we changed that to yellow to keep that separate, so you can pause it if you want to check your work. All right, how about this one? Top left, right? Which of those is the derivative of the other? Sine's the derivative of cosine, right? No, wait. Cosine's the derivative of sine. But the fact that I have this cubed on the cosine is an indicator that I'm going to want to use u as cosine x, right? You'll see in a little bit, okay? So let's go here. Let's go u. U equals cosine of x, right? So du dx would equal negative sine x. Am I recording this? No, I'm not. Yes, I am. Okay, so du, you probably are already seeing some of the tendencies, right? I don't see a negative sine x up there, do you? Du. No, I don't, right? So I'm eventually going to bring this negative over here and make that a positive, right? Because then I have sine x dx. So negative du equals sine x dx. So my integral here will be no longer cosine cubed, but u cubed du, right? Because the sine x dx is taken care of by the negative du. And I pull that negative out in front, and now I can integrate. Okay, now somebody's going to say 3x squared. That's not it. Don't say 3x squared. What's the integral of u cubed? 1 fourth u to the fourth, right? So it's negative u to the fourth over 4. Plus c. Don't forget plus c. So our answer should be negative cosine to the fourth x over 4. If you put negative 1 fourth cosine to the fourth x, that's fine as well. Oh, don't forget. Let's see. Make sure you check your work when you're ready. Typically, you guys, the denominator in a rational function is the best option for your u. And when your denominator is your rational in your rational function is your u, typically you'll end up with a natural log, because you'll be plugging a u in the denominator and it just works out nicely. There are uglier versions, which we'll get to in a moment, but your answer should be the natural log of the absolute value of sine x plus c. What's nice about A that isn't so nice about B? The squared, right? Because the derivative of the inside is the outside, right? With just that 2 hanging off the edge. But the inside, derivative of the inside of the second one, derivative of that is 1, and then we got issues, right? Because the derivative of the inside doesn't end up giving us any help with the outside. So this is called change the variable. I'm going to show you how you want to go about this. I'm not going to use that one. I'm using a different one. I'm just using a different one. Okay, so my suggestion to you is anytime that there is a radical of any sort, the u is typically going to be whatever's inside of that. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and start there. I'm going to start with u being x plus 2. Okay, so du should equal the derivative of this, dx, right? Derivative of that is 1, so du is actually just equal to dx, 1 dx. Now, this is actually genius, but it doesn't get, you just don't see it right away. But I don't have an x when I take the derivative of u. But, what? You see it? Diogo, you see it? What is x? Well, x, yeah, Wyatt? Is u minus 2. X is u minus 2. X is just u minus 2. So I can plug in, right, for x, this x is going to be u minus 2 times the square root of u. Okay, now we can do some stuff with this because x dx is equal to du. I can just tag that on the end. And now I can distribute this square root of u to each of those terms. So what is u? What power is u being taken to in the square root? 1/2. And this is over here? Or 2/2, right? If I multiply exponent, if I multiply the bases, the exponents do what to each other? They add. So u times square root of u is u to the 3/2. And square root of u times negative 2 is negative 2. U to the, I could write square root of u or u to the 1/2. Okay, I did hear someone say, how is du equal to dx? Well, the derivative of u is just 1. So du dx is equal to 1, therefore du equals dx. Du equals dx. Now, where would we go from here? Because the integral of these fractional exponents are kind of ugly, right? I go backwards, right? So what would the power be? Instead of 3/2, it'd now be 5/2. I'd add 1, and I'd multiply by 2/5. The derivative of that should give me u to the 3/2. The reciprocal. Reciprocal, yep. Unless, in this case, obviously there's a coefficient attached, right? So minus. Now, the exponent is going to be 3/2, but 3/2 gets multiplied by something to give me 2. Four-thirds, right? Four-thirds. Another way you could think of this is 2 times 2/3. 2 times 2/3. Just keep the 2 there and bring the 2/3 down in front, right? So I get 2/5 u to the 5/2 minus 4/3 u to the 3/2 plus c, and then I plug in for u whatever u equals, which was x plus 2. Is sneakily a word?